But first up tonight, how well off will you be when you retire? The experts are now telling us we'll need, get this, $500,000 in super. That, they say, is just the bare minimum to pay for the basics like food and electricity. And if you like a bit of the finer things like restaurants and holidays, you might need to take an urgent look at your savings plan. Here's 6.30's Eddie Meyer.
They might all be playing the same game, but in life, as in bowls, outcomes are uncertain. Planning for retirement may be lost in the exuberance of youth. Older heads, though, know its worth. Retired butcher John Facer worked in an era where there was no super. He entered retirement with $8,000 and a small inheritance, but at 83, it's almost gone.
I'm very fortunate that I own my own place, so we'll be able to get a bit out of that to keep going. I'm 83, so you can't go forever.
At 71, Graham Constable has been retired just a year, self-employed for much of his working life. Again, he ended up with very little super. He loves retirement, but he had to sell his car and continues to make sacrifices.
I would love travel, but I can't see myself doing it because I just won't be able to afford it. And I think that's the thing that people got to think about. You've got to sort of have something behind you so you can do, keep your same lifestyle that you have had, and that's where you miss out if you don't have some sort of super.
These stories are hardly unusual, even for those who've had the benefits of compulsory superannuation. It seems we just don't consider how long we'll be in the game, funding many more years in retirement than we may have the money to pay for.
So you work hard, save hard, you get to 65 and you have a pile of cash. How long will it last? Well, the estimate is that $150,000 will run out by the time you're 71. $300,000 only lasts until you're 80. $500,000, a lot of money, well, you'll run out at 89.
Thing is, we're living longer, a point considered by financial services firm Challenger.
But nearly everybody in our economy is used to receiving a regular income. And then in retirement, we actually turn people into investors. We give them these great big sums of money. We've talked about $500,000, so most people have never had that in their hands until they retire. And then all of a sudden they have to work out, well, how much is that going to produce? How long will that last? What's it going to do?
Challenger's view is that as good as it is, just amassing super isn't enough. To make it last longer, it's advocating new financial products that would turn a super lump sum into pension-style payments that would last your lifetime, no matter how long you live.
The cynic in me says that this is your business, so you would be suggesting this, wouldn't you?
We would, and we're not saying it's for everybody, and we're not saying that your entire retirement savings ought to be saved like that.
Cynicism aside, others say it's an issue that can't be ignored.
It's great that there's light shone on it, because it allows people to realise and identify that they've got to address it immediately, like right now. And the earlier they address it, the more chance they have of making up the difference.
And financial advisor Wilson Luna agrees the work doesn't end once you've built the nest egg. You have to do more than just hope for the best.
Manage it. And when I say manage it, whether you're using an advisor or you're managing it yourself, the same rule applies. You have to look over it, because even if you do outsource that responsibility, it's still your money.
And with the wisdom that comes with age and experience, a life lesson for younger generations who may not be ready to hear it.
So you think they don't think about retirement?
No, they don't, no. And all of a sudden that hits them, you know. But if they put their little cash away earlier, makes it much easier later on.